joined the board of directors in June of 2011, and then shortly thereafter, really just a few weeks after that, they asked me to join as the CEO. And at that point in time, you could see the company was just in a very distressed situation. The combination of a heavy debt load, on top of that, you're seeing energy prices just plummet to kind of all-time lows. The company will probably be headed to a full restructuring, which included a bankruptcy, which in fact we did file for bankruptcy on November 1st of 2011. The existing board of directors has essentially all resigned. The existing management team, the executive management team, also had resigned. And that also immediately created a bit of distrust between the existing workers, and now here comes these people from another company that we used to compete with.
What caused you to want to address culture while you were in the midst of these financial issues that were threatening the company's existence, actually?
Recognize we have to do a financial restructuring, and that was imminent. Operationally, we had to restructure the company as well, drive reliability of the assets, also getting the right people in the right spots to run the organization the right way. And third, but most importantly, it was the cultural restructuring that had to take place. And you're just not going to be successful with the other two, or the success with the other two elements of the restructuring would be fleeting if the culture wasn't changed with it. Immediately after exiting bankruptcy is when we started this process with Sen Delaney. We call it energizing you, powering our communities, to try to capture, you know, our employees, our communities, our plants, and everything that we do. And we have our values that are associated with it.
Why did you see Sen Delaney as a partner to help you in the culture shaping?
What I found with Sen Delaney is that it's actually a structured approach to addressing culture. But what I really liked about Sen Delaney, and as you see in this room around us, we have the posters all around us on the concepts. There's a whole host of the concepts like that that are easy to understand, easy to implement, and very repeatable and very coachable. And so it was a way that it was, to me, understandable, and to me, we could actually get this done and have it make a difference.
Pretty remarkable, coming out of bankruptcy, and 3 months later, you're starting to make acquisitions. Talk a little bit about that, because obviously that creates a cultural dynamic in itself.
Certainly, when we exited bankruptcy, we were a very forgettable player in power generation. And we started slowing the tide of people leaving, and you know, as you go through and you make it through the bankruptcy, well, they're tough times, but as you come out, we did our first acquisition 3 months after exiting bankruptcy, so that really sends a signal that things are different.
I know you acquired AER, Ameren Energy Resources.
It was one where Ameren was in the final stages of negotiation with a different third party, and we were able to get our foot in the door. I was able to go out and meet with Tom Voss, who was at the time the CEO of Ameren, to talk about give us an opportunity to compete for the business. What I kind of remember the most is when we went out to Ameren and sat at the table with Tom and his staff, and I had my team there. It was really interesting in that around the walls were the very same posters that are here. They were a Sen Delaney company. And I would say the reason why we got the acquisition from Ameren rather than the third party, and as Tom would explain to me, the other third party had a financially a better offer, but when it came to which company do you trust more, which company do you want to take over the relationship with your employees, your stakeholders, your bondholders, that was us. And that's because of the kind of company that Tom viewed we were, and had a lot to do with the culture that we were trying to build. And I thought that was particularly unique, that we're kind of starting from the same foundation of how do you build the right culture in a newly created company.
Talked about the acquisitions, you've been acquiring companies, talk about the success of those, your financial results. What's occurred since those early days coming out of bankruptcy?
Today we sit at 26,000 megawatts. And maybe the thing that I remember the most during the transformation is it was August of 2014, where we announced on the same day the acquisition of two unrelated companies, each of them with about 6,000 megawatts. And we simultaneously negotiated two transactions, one unrelated to the other. And on the very same day in August, we announced for the combined purchase price, when you put them both together, was over $6 billion. At that time, the enterprise value of Dynegy was $4 billion. So we had to raise upwards of $7 billion on a company working from a base of $4 billion. So give you an idea of the magnitude of what we announced that day with these two acquisitions. But the Houston Chronicle had a headline that day in the newspaper that said, Dynegy back among the power elite. So financially across that time, and we've outperformed all of our peer groups on share price performance, kind of the ultimate measure, but the amount of financial contribution of these new acquisitions, if we hadn't done those things, I mean, Dynegy today would probably not exist. We just released our third quarter results and we had $350 million of EBITDA for the quarter. And we've really transformed from a heavy coal portfolio to now 90% of our margins come from natural gas-based generation. So not only did it help us outperform our peer groups, we didn't have the agility to do those kinds of things. If we had a share price today, it would be in the single digits if we hadn't done these things. So it really gets back to the culture just really energizes an organization. Everything around mistrust is gone. Turnover is way down. And I think the ironic part of it all is that those people who left, we've had quite a few that actually have come back. And we've proven through these turbulent times, particularly in Houston, where it's an energy-intensive economy, we've been the stable one. It really comes down in a big difference today versus then is back then, folks didn't think we could win. You don't hear that anymore, right? It's people know that we're out there to compete, we're out there to win, we're out there to be faster and better than everybody else out there.
Where to from here? So obviously it's a tough market right now. It's conditions are challenging in the industry.
I think the periods of difficult times offer the greatest opportunities, and the fact that we tripled in size during three of the most difficult years in power generation for decades is a testament to that. What I see for Dynegy is continue to build upon where we've been the last few years, continue to have that winning philosophy, continue to bring agility to the marketplace, and take advantage of the dislocations in the market. The success today has been driven by the culture that we've been working on. You know, and everything that we've been able to accomplish, it's because we've developed a culture that's formulating around the kinds of things we want to do. To see the type of culture that's developed because of what the executive management team has done and how that's cascaded, how people have embraced it, and how people are, you know, providing their own level of leadership to their groups or to their job. It's just great to be part of.